Hello guys, Tuesday the 2nd of April 2013. I finally built the old engineering desk. Let's have a look. Well, there she is. I got her in position. Now unfortunately this part of the house, on my wife's bedroom and this bedroom, like it just falls off, like it's uneven. You know, from about where that leg is there to the wall, because these guys that do the maintenance and the building work around here, well damn, I sure as hell wouldn't employ them. Obviously they didn't souvenir up a proper subfloor or take care of whatever was laying down there, and they probably just rammed this stuff on top with the odd bit of ply or hardboard. I have no idea. It creaks like buggery when you walk on it. But miraculously, I've lived here 4 months and none of these laminate flooring is coming up yet, but I say it will do. Anyway guys, so this leg ain't even touching the floor over here, look. So I'm going to have to shore that up with some kind of rubber matting or cardboard, I don't know, maybe cardboard temporarily. I did score some free rubber matting that's in the trunk of my other car, the boot of my other vehicle, over on my mate's driveway there. So, not a biggie, it ain't gonna fall over, I mean, it's rock solid, I built it for God's sake. Anyway, as you can see what I've done, I've gone for 4x2 wood all the way around, including the legs, because it cost me $10 for everything. Professionally sawn up to size at the actual DIY store with their circular saw machine, you know, I paid a bit for that, but it weren't that much. It cost me 25 cents a cut actually. And I scanned them out of 2 cuts, so that worked out. As you can see, big lag bolts, rammed them in like anything. You know, I've really hammered them home. And didn't have any power tools to build this thing, and I've actually ripped out muscles in my arms, you know, hand screwing these things in. I mean, I really laid into this thing, and it's definitely solid. Not only have I got those big bolts and screws and bolts connecting the damn legs and these bits of wood together, if you go from here, I've got 4-inch bolts going into the bloody top of this thing, this worktop thing that I found for nothing. That's the only free thing I got. I'm in for about $35 to build it. What's that, 20 quid? It's 4 foot wide, roughly, I would imagine. Let's measure it. I have actually no idea how wide it is. I'm going to put the camera down a second here. What have I got here? Sorry, I'm wrong. It's 43 inches wide. Well, that's good enough. I mean, it definitely takes 2 big stereo units with some space left. They're not even touching, look. So, you know, these stereos have been on the damn floor, which was really beginning to pee me off. So it's good that they ain't on the floor anymore. That's my 1975 Tanberg, $400 any day of the damn week. Extruded aluminium frontage, no carnage at all. Every button going, everything pops in and out perfectly. I mean, everything's well weighted. This thing is a gold mine, especially with the original cables I have. And here's my Onkyo from what we looked at that before, 1989, when it was something, maybe an 88. I think it's an 89, and this is some serious audiophile stuff, and it's got like a scratch here, which I've just tried to bang out with, I had like 35, 40 bottles of this, maybe 50 of them. I bought these in 2002, just when it went out of fashion. If you're a Fainian Rich Turtle Wax, it's car polish, big bottles too. And now I knocked them out for $3 each back in the day and made a bit of corn on that, and still got 2 or 3 bottles left. But as you can see, it hasn't really got rid of it. So maybe that's why it was so cheap, hey? So if necessary, I'm just going to masking tape that off. I'm going to remove the back anyway and probably spray that over matte black. Yeah, I might not need it. If I have to, if I can't find anything to remove that, I'm just going to satin gloss that tiny little bit. You know, be masking tape all over here. And you won't even notice it. I'll polish it out anyway. And the only other carnage I can see needs a bit of a 1500 mil grit sandpapering down there, and I'll blow that over. I'll just blow the whole lot over there at the top of it. A little bit of carnage on the bottom too. which again will just be this actual side panel is not affected, just this little panel on the bottom here, so that'll be an easy rectifier. It has all the legs, and it looks stunning, works perfectly, needs a good clean. Glad to get it off the floor, to be honest. And yeah, this unit is going to be good for photographing. Like, if you went like, not like that, you don't want to see that, but if you went like that, you see the shiny wood, and that's going to be great for photographing things on, guys. I'll shine up a bit more. Got a little scratch here, nothing to worry about. But yeah, for 20 quid, I can't complain. And I've got plenty of space underneath. Actually, probably going to do a side brace on it too. I'm going to brace from here to here. Doesn't really need it, but I'll probably do that anyway. And since it's a test rig, I'm probably just going to like L-bracket these speakers up. These are just crap home stereo speakers that I've got for nothing, and they're just for a test rig. Anyway, good to get things off the ground, guys, and there's $600 worth of stereo equipment right there, any day of the damn week. And the one on the left will be sold before the other one. The other one's a long-term project, but like I said, I've got the original cables. So there you go, it's a money maker. And shame I had to use so many swear words building it, because I really did. Drove me up the damn wall, this thing. And